Today, our guest is the head of East-West Research Center, Araston Orujulu. Today, we'll discuss the event held today on occasion of 11 March, Great People's Day. Who attended this event? What decisions were made? What was the goal? The event's goal was to support the 11 March Great People's Day initiated by the Azerbaijan youth and to discuss the recent measures of Azerbaijan authorities taken against the youth. The event was arranged urgently and in a very short period. Yesterday we decided to come together for today and discuss the issue. The main goal of the event was to support the youth and their will to use their constitutional rights to demonstrate our position on the recent measures, specifically the arrest of youth in recent days, and also to show that the youth are not alone. The civil society representatives, including prominent public figures, lawyers, media representatives, defend them. What can you say about the essence of the 11th March? The people think that there will be protests in the streets, slogans will be voiced, there will be attacks, etc. What is the essence of virtual protest? We don't only speak about the virtual protest. The representation of the issue, as you said, is the approach of Azerbaijan authorities. Because the Azerbaijan authorities is used to present any action as threat to the country, the nation. After that, tries to prevent it by using force, arresting people, beating them. In the same way, the attitude toward this action is no different than the previous ones. So what is 11 March Great People's Day? First, it is a youth protest against the restrictions imposed by the Azerbaijan ruling regime on fundamental rights and freedoms. So here, we don't only speak about any concrete meeting or action in a set place. We speak about the expression of the protest against the governmental policy. So it can be expressed as a group working of youth in the city. It may be an entertainment event. They can also hold a protest meeting. It is absolutely different action. It can cover all layers of social and political life. You also adopted a statement today and noted the three youth arrested with regard to approaching 11 March. Who are they? Which network do they represent? Why they were arrested? And what does your statement focus on? Our statement first aims at supporting the youth. It is a signal to the government to stop the violence. The arrest of three youths has no legal basis at all. These are youth activists. Two are part members. One, Bakhtiar Hajiyev, is an independent youth activist. First, Jahbar Savalanlı, youth member of Azerbaijan Popular Front Party, was arrested. He was very active on social networks. He is a student of Sumgayit State University. He was arrested after narcotics was found on him. Actually, the narcotics had been planted on his clothing. Look, who else has been arrested on this charge? I know Mirza Sakit, for example. Journalist Enola Fethullahev. Narcotics was found on him in prison. It was set up to avoid execution of imminent European Court of Human Rights decision. This is absurd. Savalanlı is a very poor guy. He comes from poor family. It was only one Azen and narcotics found on him. Then how could he obtain the narcotics? Dayanet Karimov, another youth activist, was arrested in the street. His arrest was only publicized 2 days later. Today I looked at the Facebook page of 11 March Great People's Day. About 30,000 persons have been invited to attend. About 3,000 users have approved the invitation. About 500 rejected. About 2,000 said they may attend. 23,000 are still waiting. What can you say about the effect of action? You see, 23,000 have not responded yet. Simply, they know that the page is controlled by intelligence services and other governmental agencies. They take the list of participants and then pressure on them. Considering it, they don't approve the invitation. Besides, the students and youth invite other people who are not on social networks as well. You know the fear, the concern of regime can be understandable. But the expression of concern is inadequate. How do you assess the general situation? You know the revolutions in Egypt, Tunis, went ached in the same way. It began with posts on social networks, the psychological, moral, ideological preparation of people, and then the protest. What is the situation in Azerbaijan? In terms of authoritarian ruling, social discontent, the inefficiency of laws, restriction of fundamental rights and freedoms, The situation in Azerbaijan is not better than in those countries. It is even worse than some of them. So I wouldn't rule out that the developments can follow in the same way as in those countries. Thank you for coming to our studio. Today our guest was the head of the East-West Researchers Center, Arastun Orucoglu. Thank you.